Hi everybody, I'm Francesca Rondone, a PhD student at IMT School for Advanced Studies Lucca, and today I'll present a paper titled The Refining Mean Field Approximations by Dynamic State Truncation, written in collaboration with Luca Bortolussi from University of Trieste and Mirko Tribastone from IMT School. Let me start by giving you some motivating example. We will present a refinement of classical mean field approximation for Markov population processes with non-differentiable drift. In the graph, you can see the estimated average queue length for a queuing system with a two-phase Coxian service time distribution. And as you can see, there's a significant error between the mean field approximation and the stochastic simulation. This system has a non-differentiable drift, so classical refinements cannot be applied to it. However, our method, setting the hyperparameter n to a suitable value, allows to match almost perfectly the stochastic simulations. So let's start from some background results. We will deal with Markov population processes, which are very common models used to represent populations of n-interacting objects. In particular, we will focus on Markov population processes evolving on subsets of the lattice of natural numbers. However, the extension to the lattice of integers is quite straightforward. And let me remark that we will not assume density dependence. So when I refer to a state of the process X, I will refer to an unscaled vector in which every component gives the number of objects in a given local state and not the proportion of object. As usual for a Markov population process, we can define the set of jump vectors and the associated rate functions. And using them, we can define the drift so that the mean field approximation of X is the solution of an ordinary differential equation having as a vector field the drift. Let me stress again that since no density dependence is assumed, we will interpret the solution to this ordinary differential equation as an approximation of the average population, of the evolution of the average population. While widely applied, it is renowned that mean field approximation can perform poorly when applied to system with a small number of agents. In fact, while Kurth's theorem guarantees that as the number of agents tend to infinity, the scaled mean field approximation will tend to the stochastic simulation, it is also true that for number of agents, usually the error is difficult to control. Here you can see again a queuing system with the two-phase Coxian service time distribution. And you can see that the error between the mean field approximation and the stochastic simulation is significant and increases with the variance of the system, since mean field approximation is insensitive to variance. Here we are considering just 10 servers. So as I was saying before, the number of agents is small and the mean field approximation performs poorly. During the years, different refinements have been proposed to overcome this limitation, and in particular, two refinements in 1 over n and 1 over n squared have been proposed. They indeed improve classical mean field approximation, as you can see here for the malware propagation model. However, they cannot be applied in the case of non-differentiable drift. So for example, they cannot be applied to our queuing system with Coxian service time distribution. And moreover, it has been shown that in presence of orbit cycles, they can perform in an unstable way, as you can see from these graphs. This has led us to propose a new method called dynamic boundary projection. To derive it, we start by defining a second process Y that keeps track of the truncation on which X is a current time. In particular, by truncation, we will intend a subset of the state space, an hyperrectangular subset of the state space, identified by an index y, and whose sides is given by a parameter n. Y is defined in such a way that its values gives the truncation on which x is at time t. And from the figure, you can get an intuition of how we define y. Basically, here we fix as a truncation the one indexed by 0, 0. And as long as x evolves on this truncation, y keeps as value 0, 0. When x performs a transition that leads us outside the truncation, also y will change its value. And the new value of y will be the truncation closest to the previous one, containing the current state of x. So in the case of the figure, the new value for y will be 0, 1. Once we define this second process, we can consider the coupled process xy, which is a continuous time Markov chain for which we can write the master equation and obtain the joint probabilities p of xy. In particular, we can write the mean of x as a function of the conditional probabilities of x given y and the marginals over y. This expression will be the basis for our approximation method, since we will proceed by first approximating the inner summation using a truncation approximation called boundary projection, and then we will approximate the outer summation by applying a mean field approximation to the process y. To approximate the inner summation, we will use an augmented truncation approximation. To do this, we fix a subset of the state space that in our case will be a truncation of the state space. And we define an approximated process by saying that whenever x would perform a transition that would take it outside the considered truncation, instead, this transition is redirected to a new target state in the current truncation. So, for example, if the original process would perform a transition from x to x prime, instead, we redirect the transition to x star, which is obtained by considering the projection of x prime on the boundary of the current truncation. And this is why we call this truncation approximation method boundary projection. For the approximated process, we can write an approximated master equation. And what we found out is that defining, redirecting the transition suitably, the generator of the approximated process keeps the same functional form as y varies over the state space, or equivalently, as we consider different truncations, the generator of the approximated process keeps the same functional form. In this way, we can use the solutions to the approximated master equation to approximate the conditional probabilities of x given y. Here we are also using another trick, which is simply to express every state in the truncation indexed by y as a state in the truncation indexed by 0 plus the vector y. And using both these approximations, we can approximate the inner sum in the previous expression. Now we still need to approximate the marginals over y, and we can proceed by steps. First, we derive exact equations for p of y using the master equation of the joint process. Then we use again the trick of that allow us to explicit the dependence of the states from y. Then again, we approximate the conditional probabilities of X given Y with the probabilities obtained using boundary projection. The set of equations we obtain can be interpreted as the master equation of a time inhomogeneous Markov population process Y of N, which approximates Y. Here, the time dependence stems from the probabilities P and Y, which are time dependent, of course. But anyway, since Y of N is a Markov population process, we can apply classical mean field approximation to it and use it to approximate the outer summation in the expression for the mean of X. What we obtain is this new expression for the mean of X, in which Y of N is obtained from the approximated mean field approximation of Y, and P of N is obtained from boundary projection by plugging Y of N in the generator of the approximated process. In the paper, we also give some theoretical results on our method. First of all, we show that it is indeed a refinement of classical mean field approximation, by showing that by setting n equals to zero, or equivalently considering no truncation, our method yields exactly the mean field approximation of the original process X. Analogously, if we consider a truncation of infinite size, so setting n equals infinity, dynamic boundary projection yields exactly the master equation of the original process. We also give a convergence result under two assumptions. First, we assume that the drift is Lipschitz continuous, which is a necessary and sufficient condition for the existence and uniqueness of the solution of mean field approximation. And second, we assume that the drift is bounded. Under these two assumptions, it can be shown that as the sides of the truncations tend to infinity, the solution of dynamic boundary projection tends to the solution of the master equation. And to prove this result, we decompose this, the system of ordinary differential equations into a linear part and a nonlinear perturbation. Then we show first convergence of the solution to the linear part, and then using a perturbative argument, we show the convergence of the solutions of the full system. Now let me show some numerical examples. We look again at the queuing system with the two-phase Coxian service time distribution. And as you can see from the graphs, applying dynamic boundary projection with the different values of the hyperparameter n, it is possible to increasingly improve the classical mean field approximation. In particular, since this particular system satisfies the hypothesis of our convergence theorem, we are guaranteed that as n tends to infinity, we will match perfectly the stochastic simulations. Then we applied our method also to the malware propagation model with the stable orbit cycles. And we found out that even if also the solution to dynamic boundary projection behave in an oscillatory way, however, the oscillations are damped, so it behaves much more stably with respect to classical mean field approximation or also to the refinements proposed in the literature. What is interesting here is that even removing the stable orbit cycles, our method is able to improve classical mean field approximations behaving comparably with the proposed expansions. Now let me say a few words about possible limitations of our approach. In fact, since dynamic boundary projection relies on truncations of the state space, it is subject to the curse of dimensionality. In fact, the number of equations needed for our method grows exponentially with the dimensionality of the state space. However, we found out that also for small values of n, the mean field approximation is improved. And moreover, simple heuristics can be applied in order to prevent n from growing too much. So for example, here we consider queuing systems with Coxian service time distribution in which the number of phases is respectively 5 and 10. So the dimensionality of the state space is increased. And the results that you see in the graphs are obtained for relatively modest truncations of the state space in which the values of n are quite small. And you can see that the mean field approximation is significantly improved. Finally, we considered an egalitarian processor sharing with two classes of customers. And we set the arrival rates of the two classes to very different values. In particular, one arrival rate is 8 times the others. And we considered the applications of dynamic boundary projection in two cases. In the first case, represented by solid lines, the sizes of the truncation were set in such a way that the components of the parameter n were proportional to the arrival rates of the corresponding classes. So we considered unbalanced bounds. In the second case, we considered balanced bounds in which all the components of the upper parameter n were equal. And this is the balanced case represented by dashed lines. And we found out that the unbalanced case performs much better than the balanced case when the number of equations between the two cases is comparable. And this shows that choosing and suitably applying an intuitive heuristic in this case is able to improve the performance of our method significantly. To wrap up, we proposed a new method for refined mean field approximation of Markov population processes. Our method can be applied in presence of non-differentiable drift and does not assume density dependence. We also show that as the size of the considered truncations tends to infinity, our method is guaranteed to converge uniformly on bounded intervals. There are still some open questions that we would like to answer to. First of all, how to choose n, and this seems to be model dependent, but it's a very important question to overcome the limitations due to the curse of dimensionality. Then we would like to apply our method to compute the mean estimates of arbitrary functionals of Markov population processes. And we would also like to extend the convergence result to the steady state case. Finally, if possible, we would like to establish rates of convergence or error bounds. With this, I conclude my presentation. For further details, please refer to our paper, Refining Mean Field Approximations by Dynamic State Truncation. And for correspondence, you can address to the email that you see in the slide. Thank you all for your attention.